I'm saying that the best way to be your best self is to improve yourself from inside out, from ground floor up. Now, those people in renovation business, how many people are in a renovation business? Steve Shaw is, but he's not here, he's coming later. Now, if in renovation business, you know there are two ways of solving a problem. One way is to cover up, right? To add a fresh paint and to buy nice furniture to make it look good. But the leaking problem will continue to cause a problem. The rotten parts will continue to rot. And your cracked foundation eventually will crack you more. So it doesn't matter what you do to make the house look better, but at the end, it's to no avail. To no avail. Another approach, which is more costly, is to fix the whole thing up. Demolish the rotten parts. Fix your foundation. Identify the source of water leakage. Well, that costs more money, but that really fixed the problem. So therefore, when you rebuild, renovate your house will stand. The same thing applies to psychology, to mental health. Okay, again, there are two approaches. One approach you say, well, you do this, you do that, then you'll be happier. You do this, you do that, you'll be more productive. The focus is on performance. The focus on activity. So my focus is on being in the world. Being, your existence, your being. Let me explain, okay? You can be happy by doing random kindness, okay? Random acts of kindness. You can be happy to express your gratitude to your grandparents, to your father. All those activities can make you happy. But a better way is to be a good person, to be a happy person. Then you do kindness automatically, not because, oh, I do kindness, you're going to be happy. A better way will be learning how to be a better person, to be a kind person, to be a positive person. You only a positive person live a positive life. That's logic, right? Some logic, right? You have to be a positive person, you have to live a positive life. You have to do all the positive things, but can still be a very negative person. Do you agree with me on that? There's so many so-called positive psychologists, positive coaches. They're scary people. Some of them, okay? They're scary people. They can be very nasty, very negative. But you have to be you can be a positive person. You can develop full potential. You can discover your true purpose in life. That will take care of all the other things, okay? So therefore, to be your best self is to improve yourself from inside out, okay? To fix what is broken, that is why I call that a healing journey. Everybody is somewhere on a healing journey. Nobody is perfect, nobody complete, nobody is without problem. We are all on the same journey of healing, from brokenness to wholeness. There are no quick fixes. We'll travel together, help each other, hopefully we can help each other to heal what is broken. And at the same time, we are also on a journey of pursuing our ideal, pursuing our dreams. The two go together. And it makes me so sad that so many able bodies, so many healthy people who don't have to worry about food, our housing, they're not worried about, and yet they live such miserable lives. They're fighting with their spouse all the time. They always complain about something, and they're so negative about everything, about future, about events. Their negativity is holding them back. I'm not going to hire someone who's so negative. I'll not be a partner with someone who's so negative. Their negativity, their pessimism, their bad habit of complaining is holding them back from what they can become. Okay? So if we're able to fix those bad problems, those bad habits, they will be freed, right? Will be liberated to pursue our dream, you know, ideals. So that's the idea, okay? So I'm proposing that the meaning is the best way it does two things, not only fix your brokenness, but also help you to discover your ideal.